My name is Bakathatla Raju. I'm from Warangal, from Telangana state. I study B.Tech Electronics from NIT Silchar. Today we are going to have a session of maths lecture on complex numbers. So I'm going to take maths subject. We're going to have before entering into the subject directly, I would like to tell you something about maths. So, all of us used to think that maths is just equations and all those things. We just afraid of maths because we think that it's so complex and it's not that much easy. It's very easy, especially for those, especially intellectuals like those guys. But it's not like that. So, mathematics, I would like to tell you some interesting points. First about maths. So mathematics is, it is considered as the kingdom of science. And it is also considered as just like our human language, so mathematics is also considered as, it's a language of nature and it's a language of God. Because we are going to nature, everything is manifested in nature, so we are going to crack it through the equations and maths, okay? So, just like, of course, in this topic also, we will see something called God's equation, so don't be think that just mathematics is equations or just like that. It has some meaning, just like our human language, it is a language of, some introduction about maths and these things, and let's come to our topic, complex numbers. So before any subject we enter into subject, first we have to know actually what is the physical significance of something, okay? So I just like this maths is the equations about some, it's a language of nature, so like that complex numbers is also, it has also some significance, okay? So whenever you go to, and learn about some subject, try to know that, so why we are learning actually. So what is the importance of something? Any subject, not only maths, it has everything has some significance. So here complex numbers. So complex numbers is, so before we entering into this, we know about numbers, all we know about numbers, just like, real numbers, we know about real numbers, all integers, all positive numbers, all negative numbers, and all those things. So have you ever been so directly in complex numbers? The introduction will start from negative numbers. So have you ever thought what is the meaning of a negative number? How could a number be less than zero? I mean, do you know that zero means literally nothing? We can say negative sometimes, but it matters a lot, of course, in computer and all those things. So negative number is like negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, 0, negative 1. So how could a number be less than? Have you ever thought like, So what is the significance of negative numbers actually? Simply, negative numbers, if you go, let's take a reference, like, let's think that here it is a zero. I mean, in a different part of view, we talk like this. So if you go, if someone is going in this direction, for example, then we take like 1, 2, and 3, like this. This is positive direction. Like positive direction. For example, someone has traveled about 3 kilometers in this direction, and someone is traveling in this direction. So like -1, -2. So if we go in this direction, then we are considering that it's positive direction. and someone is traveling to the opposite of the direction, then we think that then we consider as the negative direction. So just in the opposite, this is the one direction, this is one direction. So in the reference to the reference to this, we are talking in the direction of this this direction. But nothing like, there is nothing like positive and negative. So this is the significance of positive and negative. We are just taking the reference of some other direction. Okay. So that is the significance of negative numbers. Okay. So something called negative. We know about positive numbers. Come to the positive numbers. Okay. So before entering to this subject directly, we have to know something about all these things. Okay. So this is significance of negative numbers. Something. We know how to find the square root of root 3, like root 4. We know something that root 2 is 1.414 and root 3 is 1. So root 3 is 1.78 and root 4 is 2. Okay, so root 4 is 2. We know all these things. We know how to find the square root of positive numbers. But have you ever thought how to find the negative root of the negative numbers, like six, root minus 4, like root minus 3? Have you ever thought about these things? How to find the square root of negative numbers? So at this point of view, we talk about this. Okay, let me draw these things. So in this context, to find the square root of negative numbers, so we talk about complex numbers, okay? It is related to something, so root minus 4. So they define something called I square equal minus 1. So we are going to square, something called I. So the I, this is also called as I, okay? So something called I. So I equal root minus 1. I will tell you what is the meaning of this and significance also. So they define something called I equal root minus 1, the imaginary number. They call it as imaginary number. Okay? They call it as imaginary number. Actually, in 16th century, a scientist, a mathematician called G. Cardano. Okay? A mathematician in 16th century. Mathematician in 16th century, G. Cardano, while he was solving the equation, a cubic equation, he introduced the concept of, he used the concept of these numbers actually. So he called it as something as, he called it as fictitious number. He called it as fictitious numbers actually. He called it a fictitious numbers, and while he was solving a cubic equation, he introduced the concept of these things. Okay, so let's see how we are going to use this actually. I equal minus 1, so I equal root minus 1, they define something. And okay, so let's see how we are going to use all these things actually. So for example, if you want to find the root minus 4, then simply you can do it as root minus 1 into 4. Okay, so root minus 1 into 4. So root minus 1 into root 4. We know about all these things. So root minus 1 is, you know, we define as I square equal minus 1 and I equal root minus 1. So we know that root minus 1 is I and root 4 is, we know, 2. So 2i. It means 2i into 2i equal 4i square. And we divide it I square equal minus 1, so it will be minus 4. So this is the significance of this I. Okay, to find the square root of a negative number, we use this I, the imaginary number. So that is the physical significance of this I and this imaginary numbers and all these things. So let's go for one. So let's talk about some properties of this imaginary I. Okay. So we declare it as something, we define I square equal to minus 1. Okay. So let's see addition of, and then we define. So now we are going to define here what is a complex number. Okay. So a complex number can be, so we are going to write the mathematical interpretation of this complex number. So z equal to a plus. A plus IB, where A comma B are real numbers. Okay? So we are defining a complex number, get that a complex number. Complex number and A plus IB and AB are the real numbers. Okay? Then and just like we define, we know this Cartesian plane, we know how to give the location for it. For example, some point is there. In Cartesian plane, we represent 1, 2 or this point here. Let's say some point P this is, and well, this is 1, and we represent this is 1, 2, 3, on y axis, like this. So P can be represented here and here. So this point is in this plane. Okay, so like this, so complex numbers also live in a plane called something called Argand plane. So this plane is called Argand plane. This is also called as complex plane. Okay, so this is, and instead of x we use here real axis, and instead of this is us. Y axis we use as imaginary axis. Okay? So if you want to maybe on this thing. So this is the Argand plane, and if you want to, so z equal, let's see, we want to represent this 1 plus 2y on the plane. So complex numbers lives in this Argand plane. So this is the real axis, instead of x, we here we define it as the real axis, and this is as imaginary axis. Okay, so 1 plus 2 is, so this is 1, and this is 1, and this is 2. So 1 comma 2. So this is the representation of this number, this complex number. And then on this, and so this is a representation of complex numbers and algebraic. So in the next lesson we will see these properties of these complex numbers and polar form and algebraic theorem of complex numbers. Okay, and this is a brief introduction of complex numbers, and don't be afraid of this topic. By its name, complex, it's not that much complex actually. If you could not interested, if you could focus, and I will try to make you understand easily. And so in the brief introduction, in the introduction first I told you that each and everything has some significance. So like that, I will try to give some real life or some application type things. Because of course these things are mostly used in, you know, complex analysis and in your Fourier, and especially in the electrical engineering. So I will try to, at the end of each lecture, I will try to give some application type, and I will make you understand. I hope so. And that's it for today. I hope that you enjoyed it. And thank you.